Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15 Beta 6 has been out for a little while, and I think it's time to try it for many of you. And I'll talk more about that, whether or not you should install it a little bit later. Now I wanted to talk about some of the features they've removed, such as SharePlay and no screen sharing in FaceTime. I mentioned this in the More New Features video, and I think this means we're getting closer to a final version where it's more refined, kind of buttoned down, and ready to go. So we're getting closer and closer to that. And as far as iOS 15 Beta 7 and those releases, I wanted to talk about that first before we get into the good and the bad based off of my experience on the iPhone 12 Pro Max and your experience based off the YouTube community poll. So as far as when to expect it, at the time of this video, I would expect it on the 24th or next Tuesday. Generally, at this point, we're at a weekly cycle, so I would expect it Tuesday or Thursday with a Beta 7 version. Then maybe a release candidate the following week or a Beta 8, and then a release candidate. So it depends how buttoned down this is and when Apple is going to release it, but I think we're going to see an Apple event in mid-September where we'll have an announcement of when to expect the final version. So that seems very likely. So maybe a couple more versions, Beta 7, Beta 8, release candidate, and then a final version sometime in mid to late September. That seems to make the most sense. Now, Apple has been working on iOS 14.8, which is a bit of a mystery since we don't really need it at this point. But it looks like we may get a final version with some security updates being able to be installed without having to install iOS 15. So maybe this is due to maybe getting rid of iPhone 6S Plus, 6S and SE in the future, but right now we don't really know when to expect that. I thought maybe we'd have a final version of that out by now or a beta, but iOS 14.8 looks to still be in the works, but we have no definitive information. It's all just speculation at this point. Now, as far as iOS 15 Beta 6 and the overall stability, it seems to be very stable for most. It's quite smooth. It was smooth with Beta 5, but for the majority of things, it's very smooth. The overall usability, the speed, and everything else seems to be getting more and more refined, like we would expect at this point with Beta 6. Performance seems to be better for most, and cellular is very much improved for me. Where I would have to constantly switch on airplane mode and turn it back off to get cellular data to work properly, it seems to be working just as you would expect in this update. So if we go to speed test, I should see some better speeds here as well. And so in speed test, if I hit go, let's see what it does. We'll give it just a moment. We're on T-Mobile here, and you'll see on 5G, well, I'm at about almost 70 megabits per second regularly. That's pretty good for download. I do have full bars, but it can be kind of congested where I am, so a lot of people can be on the network at once, and you'll see 33 megabits per second up. That's pretty good. So I have no complaints as far as that goes. So we'll wait for that. And so pretty good, 65 and 34. So the overall speed has been improved. Wi-Fi seems to be okay for me, not everyone, and I'll talk more about that in a moment. Also, most people are saying Spotlight search is much improved. So those that were having issues with Spotlight are saying that it's better. There's more information in it, more apps, and it seems to be just a much better search optimization of what it was before. So Beta 6 seems to be getting that right as far as that goes. Now, as far as widgets, I've been having far less issues myself. Some people have been having issues, but I see far less issues personally. Now, I haven't seen if anyone else is having these issues, but no one really reported that widgets were having a problem. Now, most people report less crashes and resprings, and also the good thing is many are saying that their banking apps are working. The ones that typically are not working right now tend to be German apps. So for some reason, some of the German banking apps are not working properly. Of course, they need to be updated, and usually they get updated closer to the final release of iOS 15. Now, as far as things that are definitely fixed in iOS 15 Beta 6, video will now play within the browser. So this is my video on iPhone 13, and you'll see that it's playing, and it's not presenting a black screen. So that seems to be much better. Also, another thing that seems to be fixed for me is much better Bluetooth connectivity. I noticed that it switches easier between Mac and iPhone and iPad, and just in general, Bluetooth seems to be improved. So that's a great sign. Not for everyone, but most people, especially if you have AirPods, they seem to be doing much better. Now also, Apple Music seems to be improved as well, so people having issues with it stopping, maybe after 15 seconds, don't seem to be having that issue as much. I haven't seen that in the comments very much, and it looks like that's fixed for the majority of people. Now it may occur from time to time, but it does appear to be fixed. Now as far as the bad or things that are happening, notifications seem to be a problem for some where it can cause an issue. Maybe you hit turn off on the notification and it crashes the screen. So that's an issue for some people. And there's also a lot of issues with live text and sort of live or visual lookup where it doesn't recognize an object. So this is my Photos app. This one is recognizing it. If we tap on the eye, you can see that it recognizes a plant, shows kind of where it's taken. And if we tap on it, we can get more options with results about what it is. So this is working for me with some things, but not everything. And even people that were seeing this before are sometimes not seeing it. And I think that's because the neural engine needs to do some more calculations and they still need to optimize this a little bit better. So that's definitely still an issue. Twitter does seem to continually crash sometimes if it hasn't been opened in a while. So it will respring sort of the app itself, not the phone, and then it will work the next time I open it. So that's definitely an issue. And some other people are having an odd storage bug. So if you go into settings and then you go to your storage, so you go to general and then you go to iPhone storage, some people are seeing system take up a huge amount of storage. So I'm not seeing this. It always kind of shows as nothing here. It says zero, but some people are seeing this take up huge amounts of storage. So it seems to be a bug for a lot of people. Now, some people are having issues in music searching for albums with the album artwork not showing up properly. And also in maps, sometimes it will crash when searching. So people have been reporting weird issues here and there. CarPlay does seem to work better for some, but is still an issue for others. So I don't know if that's specific to the manufacturer of car you're using with CarPlay. And then again, there continues to be issues with Wi-Fi and cellular for some. I think they're much better in beta 6 than they were with beta 5, but some people are still having this issue. So hopefully they fix it. Like I said, 5G seems to be much better for me with this update. I haven't had to reset it once using airplane mode, so that's a great sign. Now, the phone is getting warm. A lot of people are mentioning that it's getting hot. Some people are even having it overheat if they have an OtterBox case on it, something that's sealed, but I haven't really experienced that myself, but quite a few people have experienced that. So the phone does get warm. In fact, it's quite warm right now, and when I tried to record a little bit earlier, it would dim the display because it was too hot outside. And you can see it's 86 degrees Fahrenheit where I am right now, and it's almost at full brightness, but there's times earlier where it was warmer or more humid and it would actually dim the display because it was at full brightness. So that continues to be an issue. Only one person this time said they have green tint though. So it does seem to be an issue. Again, I'm not sure if this is hardware or software related, but if it's software, I would expect a fix sometime around now. Apple fixed it in about this time last year with the iPhone 11 Pro and Pro Max, but we still haven't seen them fix it. And so that leads me to, should you install iOS 15 beta 6? And I would say at this point, as long as you have a backup, you've created a backup in your settings with backup under iCloud or on a computer with iTunes, Mac, or Windows, then sure, go ahead and install it. But you will need a computer to go back. But it seems to be the most stable version by far for me. And I think most people are reporting this. So at this point, I would say that it's safe to install. Now, as far as battery life overall, my battery life has been pretty good. If we go to battery life, you'll see my battery health is at 95%. And as I've said many times before, the updates don't affect the battery health. In fact, it's been 95% since I installed beta 6. They just recheck the physical capability of the battery. And over the last 10 days, we can take a look at today, I had 2 hours and 46 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 1 minute of screen off time, which isn't great because I used 50%. Again, 2 hours and 48 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 16 minutes of screen off time, which is pretty good for this beta. I would say 6 to 8 hours is normal. It just depends on the day. But someone did send me a screenshot of their battery life on a 12 Pro Max that has increased greatly. So we'll go into that. So thanks to Jessica for sending this along. You can see she got 8 hours and 21 minutes of screen on time, 56 minutes of screen off time using Facebook and Google and Instagram. If she didn't have Facebook, I bet she would save a ton and even get 10 10 to 12 hours of screen on time, which was normal with iOS 13. So that seems to be pretty good. And she does have low power mode on now, but in general, it's quite good since she's only used about 90% of her battery life. So again, 8 to 12 hours of screen on time, depending on the apps you're using, seems to be pretty good. And let's take a look at the iPad quick as well. Now on iPadOS 15 Beta 6, if we go into the settings and then we go to battery life, wait for it to load here, you can see over the last 10 days, it was charged at 8:38 a.m. today to 100%. And yesterday I had 3 hours of screen on time, 1 hour and 42 minutes of screen off time. So far today, I've only used it about an hour and it's at 79%. So I'm still getting about 6 hours of screen on time. I had hoped it would bump up since uninstalling or turning off background app refresh last week, but it seems to only get 6 to 8 hours of screen on time. I would expect this to improve, hopefully within the next time we have an update or by the time it's finally released. As far as anything else on iOS 15 or iPadOS 15 Beta 6, I've had no issues whatsoever. It's been super stable for me on the iPad. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. And at the time of this video, there's 16,000 votes. So thank you to everyone that voted. I really appreciate it. And it helps us get a better idea of what it's like overall. And 34% of you are on iOS 15 Beta 6. 54% of you are on iOS 14.7.1, the current public release. 4% of you are on iOS 14.6 or older. 2% are on iOS 13 or older, just like before. And 7% are on Android. This seems to match up to the previous week as well, very closely with iOS 12 or 13 and Android. So thank you again to everyone that voted. I really appreciate it. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. So there's 253 at the time of this video, and let's go through a few of them. Colin1C says, I'm on beta 6 on my iPhone XS, and there are some issues when launching apps. Milo says, iPhone 11, battery on standby is draining slightly quicker, but screen time is the same. No noticeable bugs for now. 2020 iPhone SE iOS 15 Beta 6 seems more stable than Beta 5. Battery life has been great with iOS 15. No significant bugs, a few unexpected behaviors from some apps, nothing that can't be remedied with a quick restart of the app. Loving it so far. Federico says, the experience has improved a lot from Beta 5 to Beta 6 on my iPhone XR. On Beta 5, I had noticeable lag and stutters. Now with Beta 6, lag is less present, but still there while doing rapid tasks such as switching between apps. AMJ95 says, performance is good on my XS Max, battery life isn't. As for bugs, I haven't noticed any based on the things I use, and just a side note, I think that Beta 5 Safari looked better and still hoping for a new control center design. Mel Harris says, very smooth, battery life is much better than Beta 5, Twitter still resprings on opening, but good after that. Mini not getting warm except when charging. Walter says, iOS 15 Beta 6 is smooth, but notice battery gets hot on certain apps, and battery life is okay, using on an iPhone XR. Rivishan Ramdath says, iPhone XR, it's pretty good. The music app is randomly deleting a few songs from a playlist for some reason. However, this could be related to another issue and not with Beta 6. Other than that, everything is running smooth. Seville Klassen 8 says, the Beta 6 has been working smoothly this time around, then the Beta 5 a little bit. But on Safari, new to iOS 14 style is nice. The battery life, on the other hand, is still not good that I can't comment on iPhone 7 Plus. Matthew says, there's still some small bugs from Beta 5 and new bugs on Beta 6. Twitter occasionally crashing, the status bar delay, but it seems to work sometimes. Focus status page is underlapping, wallpaper still have the green line, media control glitches in a bit in the landscape, but still livable. Battery drain seems to be the same to Beta 5, but standby drain seems to be worse. It was 61% at night, then 52% in the morning. It dropped around 0.2% in Beta 5. Every time I turn off the phone before I sleep, I always turn off the Wi-Fi and put on power saving mode. Yes, it's weird, but I do that to save battery. That wouldn't save battery as Wi-Fi uses less power than cellular does. So I would suggest leaving that on unless you turn it on airplane mode. Also, turned off sleep focus mode before going to sleep and it dropped from 57% to 54%. iPhone 12, 100% capacity. Rounds ZZ says, so good, nice performance and good battery life on iPhone 12. Raul Anand says, good on my iPhone XR, but the banking app is still not working. So that's everything with iOS 15 Beta 6. Of course, we're looking forward to the final release in about, well, about a month or maybe even less. We don't really know, but we should have an event in September, maybe two events, but at least an event in September, maybe October, and maybe even November as well. So I'm looking forward to iOS 15, iPadOS 15, watchOS 8, and of course those new MacBooks. I'm really looking forward to those because I edit on them all day, so I'm looking forward to even better performance. But let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.